Good afternoon, students. Welcome to our 11th standard students. Today we can discuss the topic unit vector. Unit vector means the modulus value is 1. Already you know very well the unit vector formula, that is a cap. If a unit vector means, we can say a cap. If you say a vector is also correct only, but it is not exact correct. If you say a cap, you can put cap size. See, let's say a cap. A cap is equal to a vector divided by modulus of a. A vector divided by modulus of a vector. See how to find modulus of a vector. If a vector is a1 I cap plus a2 j cap plus a3 k cap, here I, j, k are unit vectors, is along the direction. See, this is a 3-dimensional axis. One is x axis, another one is y axis, this is z axis. If your direction of x axis is I cap, the direction of y axis is j cap, the direction of z axis is k cap. If you any point taking a point, any point a1, a2, a3, we can write like this. This is the vector form. A vector equal to a1 I cap, since it is a coordinate of x axis, that only you can put I cap. This is a2 j cap, that is a coordinate of y axis. This is a3 k cap, it is a coordinate of z axis. Suppose you want modulus of this. Modulus of a vector is equal to root of a1 square plus a2 square plus a3 square, square root of. This is a formula. Suppose they are asking direction ratio. Direction ratio means, that is direction ratio of a vector. What is a vector? A1 I cap plus A2 j cap plus A3 k cap. So the direction ratio of a vector is equal to A1 comma A2 comma A3. You can put the bracket. It's a coordinate point form. Next, direction cosines. Direction cosines means this cos theta, you know, that is only. The direction cosines, that is A1 by modulus of a vector plus a2 by modulus of a vector comma a3 by modulus of a vectors. Okay, the next point, if two vectors, any two vectors, suppose you can say ac vector comma ab vector, are collinear. Or collinear. Collinear means is I and A same line. What is the meaning of collinear? It's I and A same straight line. That's only collinear. Or if you are asking three points, there's a point means there's a position vectors. Three points are collinear. Three points are collinear. That is the condition is AC equal to M times of AB. That's some constant times, any constant. 4 times, 3 times, 5 times, like that. Or modulus of AC vector equal to AB vector plus BC vector. Modulus of AB vector plus BC vector. Modulus of AC vector. This is the condition for collinear. For example, see, find a unit vector along means is the same directions. Suppose they are asking both direction means same and opposite, along same and opposite. See, direction of the vector 5i vector plus 3j vector plus 4k vector. Okay, we know that what is the unit vector formula, that is A vector modulus of A vector, that is A vector modulus of A vector. So the unit vectors 5i vector minus 3j vector plus 4k vector. So we can put like this, A vector divided by modulus of A vector. Here what is A vector? 5i vector minus 3j vector plus 4k vector. This modulus, modulus of 5i vector minus 3j vector plus 4k vector. What is the modulus formula? Root of a square, a 1 square plus b 1 square plus c 1 square. Here also the 5 square minus 3 square means minus minus plus. So plus 3 square plus 4 square. 3 square is 9, 4 square is 16, 5 square is 25. Add this 3 means root 50. This is called a unit vector. So you can understand which how to find a unit vectors. If a given one vector means you can take this is a vector, that is a unit vector along the same direction. See, a vector divided by modulus of a vector. How to find modulus? Root of a 1 square plus a 2 square plus c a 3 square. Okay. See, now we have another unit vector parallel to in the opposite direction. Opposite direction means we can put simply minus symbol. Note, we can put where. Suppose they are asking same direction means this. So opposite direction means this. If you are asking both direction means you can put plus or minus. You can put plus or minus. Plus minus. Okay. That is both directions. See, next they are asking find the direction ratio, direction ratio and direction cosines. Already I told you, know what is the direction ratio? A1 comma A2 comma A3. What is the direction cosines? A1 by modulus of A vector, A2 by modulus of A vector. So here given two vectors. The first one is 3i plus 4j minus 6k. Next 3i cap minus 4k cap. First of all the direction ratio of this. See, what is the direction ratio? 3i cap plus 4j cap minus 6k cap, or 3 comma 4 comma minus 6. 3 comma 4, this is called a direction ratio. Direction ratio. Direction cosine means, that is a by r means modulus of a vector. See, x by r, suppose you can take this vector xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap means x by r comma y by r comma z by r. So we can find the modulus r vector is equal to root of x square plus y square plus z square. Here the consider which one is a vector, that is a x I vector plus y j vector plus z k vector. You can say vector or cap, anyone is same. Okay, x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap is also like that, x I vector y plus y j vector plus z k vector. If you find the modulus means, what is the modulus? Root of 3 square plus 4 square plus minus 6 square. This is 9 plus 16 minus 4. This is 36. What is that? Is 52, 61, root of 61, like that. So we can put 3 by root 61, comma 4 by root 61, minus 6 by root 61. You can understand, find the modulus and divide. You can put comma, comma in between. This bracket is also accepted. Okay, this is a direction cosines. This is called a direction cosines. The next problem, 3i cap minus 4k cap. So in between j terms are missing. So we can write the direction ratio is 3 comma j term missing only, you know, that one will put 0. 0 comma minus 4. Next we can find the modulus means root of 3 square plus 0 square plus minus 4 square. Minus 4 square means 16. 0 square means 0. So 9. 16 plus 9, 25. Root 25 means 5. So the direction cosine is 3 by 5, comma 0 by 5, minus 4 by 5. Okay. The direction cosines always denoted by the symbol cos alpha comma cos beta comma cos gamma. Cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma. If there is a condition of direction cosines, it's a main conditions, it's a cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is always equal to 1. If you're getting the answer is 1 means that only say it is the direction cosines of the any vector. Otherwise it is not a direction cosines. See the example. Find the direction cosines of the vector whose direction ratio given. Okay. Next one. These angles make some direction cosines or not. 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree. See. First of all, you can find the direction cosines. X by root of this. Root of x square plus y square z square means that's a modulus. So if you find the modulus of the given vector, 2 comma 3 comma minus 6. 2 comma 3 comma minus 6. 2 square is 4. 3 square is 9, 4 plus 9, okay, next plus 36, that is a 49, 49, root 49 means that is a 7. So, the direction cosines are 2 by 7, they are given only 2 comma 3 comma minus 6 only, no? What is the direction cosines? 2 comma 7, 3 comma 7, minus 6 comma 7. How to get 7? Root of 2 square plus 3 square plus minus 6 square. So we get to root 49. Root 49 means 7. Next, what is the condition for direction cosines? Cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is equal to 1. Here they given the angle 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree. So we can we can 30 degrees alpha, 45 degrees beta, 60 degrees gamma. So cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is equal to cos 30 degree. What's cos 30 degree? What's the cos 30 degree? Root 3 by 2. So root 3 by 2 whole square means 3 by 4. What is the cos 45? 1 by root 2. Cos 45 is 1 by root 2. So 1 by root 2 whole square means that is 1 by 2. What is cos square 60? Sorry, cos 60, 1 by 2. 1 by 2 square means 1 by 4. If you add this, take the LCM, what's the LCM? 4. 4 means we get 3 plus 2 plus 1. 3 plus 2 plus 5, 6 by 4. 6 by 4 means you never get 1. If you get answer is 1 means that is a direction cosine. Otherwise, it is not a direction cosine. So, therefore, they are not direction angles of any vector. See, next they are given 2 points, 2 comma 3 comma 1 and 3 comma minus 1 comma 2. They are asking line joining points. The direction cosine of the line joining point. If you are given 2 minus, you can take x1, y1, z1, that is the first point. The second point, x2, y2, z2. The line joining point. The line joining points are x2 minus x1, comma, y2 minus y1, comma, z2 minus z1. See, x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, z2 minus z1. If you are given two points, 2 comma 3 comma 1, next one, 3 comma minus 1 comma 2. Here coming the first point, you can say x1, y1, z1. Next one, x2, y2, z2. That is x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, z2 minus z1. That is 3 minus 2, minus 1 minus 3, 2 minus 1. Okay, what is the answer? 3 minus 2 means 1. So minus 4, you say 1. So the line joining point is 1 comma minus 4 comma 1. How do you get it? You can consider the first point x1, y1, z1. The second point x2, y2, z2. Okay. The line joining point is x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, z2 minus z1. Okay, next. We can find the direction cosines. So finally we can get the vector form is 1 comma minus 4 comma 1 only. So we can like the vector form I vector minus 4 j vector plus k vector. The direction cosine is 1 comma root of 1 square minus 4 square plus 1 square. We get the answer is root 18. So 1 by root 18, 4 by root 18, 1 by root 18. Okay, so understand or not? Suppose they are asking opposite direction means we can change the sign. Opposite direction. 1 means minus 1. Minus 4 means plus 4. This is called the opposite directions. The next one, direction cosines are given. They are asking unit vector. Unit vector means, see, the same direction. that is a 2, 3, 3, 6, 6 by 7. We can find the modulus of this given vector 2, 3, 6. What is the modulus? Root of 2 square plus root of 3 square plus root of 6 square. Okay, that's a 25 we get. So that is 25 means 5. So they are asking they have lost the, find the direction ratio of the vectors that are 2, 3, 7 and its magnitude 5 means you can multiply by 5. Find the vectors. See if it is, this is the direction cosines. Direction cosine means 2 by root of 2 square plus 3 square plus 6 square. 3 by root of 2 square plus 3 square plus 6 square. 6 by root of 2 square plus 3 square plus 6 square. That is root of 49. 49 means 7 will come. So this is the unit vectors. Which one is called a unit vector? A vector divided by modulus of A vector. This is also like that. If A multiple magnitude 5 means we can simply multiply 5. So that is a 5 by 7 2i cap plus 3j cap plus 6k cap. In your textbook, sometimes they will put a cap, the I cap, j cap, k cap. Sometimes they write simply I vector, j vector plus k. So hereafter you must write the only cap, since I, j, k always called unit vectors. So you can put the cap symbol. I cap plus j cap plus k cap. Thank you, students.